Welcome to Hypercast, Hyperic's biweekly series of educational webcasts focused on Hyperic HQ and enterprise systems management best practices. My name is Gerardo, and I'm a software engineer here at Hyperic. You might remember me from some previous Hypercast where I talked a little bit about developing plugins with JMX and Oracle containers for Java. So without further ado, let me briefly go over our agenda for today. So I will be talking about the new feature in Hyperic HQ, which is the JMX console. I will be walking you through an actual example where we will be building and deploying a JMX-enabled application, which then you will be monitoring using our JMX console. Finally, we'll go into a little bit more of an advanced topic, which is how you can set up your own JMX console filters for your application. So, to give you some motivation of the JMX console, basically the JMX console is implemented as an HQU plugin, and it provides the following capabilities. It allows you to read your application's JMX MBean attributes. It allows you to invoke simple JMX MBean operations, and it also allows you to query the MBean server for your running JVM using the standard JMX object name pattern. So you can select only those MBeans that you are most interested in. Finally, it's also to prevent clutter in the UI by filtering for only those attributes and operations that you are particularly interested in because of your application. You can filter attributes and operations based on Java regular expressions. I will go through a brief example of how you would actually go about building and deploying a JMX-enabled application. So the first thing you will need to do is instrument your application in order to register MBeans with its JVM's MBean server. And that way you can expose attributes and operations that are of interest to your application. So I have here actually an example that I've developed for the demo that I can show you how you would go about doing that. So here I have an example of a Java class, which is JMX console demo, which implements an MBean interface. If we're interested in the MBean interface, we can go in here, and this is the interface that defines our JMX attributes and operations that we can then operate on from the JMX console. Here we see that we have a number of attributes, one of which is count. So we have the standard Java bean setter, set count, and getter, get count. We're also exposing a couple of operations, one of which is increment, and one of which is decrement. So as we can see from this interface, what this class actually does is very simple. It basically keeps an internal count, which we can increment and decrement in JMX, and then we can read that count at any time using the JMX attribute. Also, in order to make this example a little bit more interesting, I inserted here another bonus operation, which is the say hello operation. I've implemented this in two different ways. The first one will just return a simple string and say hello followed by the name that's passed in. The second one is that will actually return hello plus the name as a Java string array return type. So if we go back to the main code, we see here how we have some logic to get the JVM's MBean server. We do a registration of this MBean, an object name. So note here, the object name is demo, colon, name, equal counter. This will be important later on as we filter for MBeans based on their object names, JMX call. And here, as I briefly talked about before, we have operations to decrement and increment the count and to get the count back, as well as the say hello application. So basically this application is really simple. All it does is it runs on the command line, waits for the user to press a key, otherwise it loops infinitely, registers this MBean with the MBean server so that the user can interact with the application through JMX. So let me go back to my slides. So that's the first build step that we just went through, is going through that your application and the particular use cases that you have and what kind of operations and attributes you want to be exposing to JMX. Once your application is built, then you have to go through the task of actually deploying it. Deploying your application so that you can actually access the JMX interface involves tuning one Java parameter in the command line, and that's the com sun management JMX remote, which we see here in the first bullet point. Basically, what that enables your application to do is it allows for remote JMX-based connections to your JVM. So once we do that step, then we can actually run the application, and I will show you how I'm doing that locally on my box. So we take a look here. I'm actually running this application that I just showed you on Eclipse. I've specified the JMX remote system variable, so the simple agent is running. Now, at this point, it's actually good practice to open a JConsole window to make sure that you actually indeed have access to your JMX interface for your application. So I'm going to pull up Java's JConsole, not to be confused with the JMX console of HQ, which is what we're talking about here in this presentation. So we pull up Sun's JConsole, we can connect to this the application that's running. This is the application I showed you on the other window. And we have access to all this general information, but at the moment we're only particularly interested in MBeans. So let's drill down into MBeans. And we see here that we have a demo node, which we can expand, and there will be a counter MBean. So if we go back to our main application IDE, you will notice how that's exactly the object name that we gave the application when we registered that MBeam. So at this point, if we return to JConsole, we open up demo and counter, we see that there's one attribute, that's the count attribute. And there are a number of operations. There's say hello as an array, increment and decrement. So let's start by incrementing the counter. There was a successful invocation of the method. Now we can go back to the attributes tab, and if we refresh this, we would expect the count to be equal to 1. Indeed, the count is equal to 1. Now we can go back to our operations and try one of these bonus operations. I'm going to make the application say my name. And indeed, here we go. That's the return type of the operation. So all this is fine. What we verified through JConsole is that we have indeed registered our JMX MBeam with MBeam server, and we have access. So once this is done and verified, then we should be able to actually use the JMX console from HQ and do the same kind of operations that we're performing here through JConsole. Which brings me to the second bullet point here under deployment steps. So once your application is up and running, you know you're allowed to connect remotely to JMX to its interfaces. Then the next thing we want to do is be able to import that JVM platform into HQ. The way that you can do this is by enabling your HQ agent to auto-discover 1.5 on JSC JVM. You can do this by going into your agent properties and adding this line, which should be something like jmx.sun.discover equals true. Another way to do this is actually by manually adding that sun JVM server type, which you can do through the UI. So once this agent properties file is, you've made the change in there, you can restart your agent. And you should see the Sun JVM that's running your JMX-enabled application. That should be auto-discovered. So then all you have to do is log into HQ and import that server type. So I'm going to show all of this from the command line and how we go about doing this. this is my agent properties. And you see here I've added this line jmx.sun.discover equal true. So after doing that, I restarted my agent and logged into my HQ application, which you can see in here. So if you notice here, this is all the stuff that's all the servers that have been auto-discovered by my agent. And one of them indeed is the SunJVM that's running my JMX console demo application. So at this point, all I need to do is add all of these server types into my inventory. Great, it's all been added. So I'm going to browse my platform from where I would be able to get to the JMX console. Okay, I'm logged into my platform. Here I see a server type for SunJVM. That's the one that corresponds to my Java process that I'm running from the command line. All I got to do is click on that. And then I can just go to views. Here we see a new HQU plugin type. That's the JMX MBean Query. This is what we've been referring to as the JMX console for the purposes of this presentation. So let me quickly return to my slides and we can continue from there. The background of what the JMX console actually allows you to do. As we've already described before, it allows you to filter MBeans based on an object name pattern. It also lets you filter attributes and operations based on regular expressions. It lets you set a refresh interval for your attribute values, and it lets you select a preset MBean filter. But all of these things I will actually show you for the example, so I know this can be quite a mouthful, but we'll walk through them, so we'll take our time to actually find out what these things mean. So let me go back to my desktop. Okay, we're back here. So by default, when you first log into this JMX MBean query view, the object name pattern is defaulted to the SunJVM MBean. So right now what we're doing is we're querying for any MBeans that are registered on the SunJVM that have this kind of object name pattern. This is not particularly interesting to us, since it's not an MBean that we define with our application. It's actually an MBean that's packaged with the SunJVM. So for the purpose of this presentation, it's actually not something that we're too interested in. What we are interested in, however, is an MBean that has this kind of object name pattern. So I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to use this as my object pattern for the query. Here we go, and sure enough, we see what we would expect. The count has a value of 1, along with the operations that we discussed before. There's increment, decrement, say hello array. So just to do the same kind of steps that I did in JConsole previously, I'm going to go ahead and increment the count. We've invoked increment, it was successful. There's no return value. So now what we would have to do in order to refresh this count can be in a couple of ways. One would be to actually query for the MBeans again, and sure enough, the count was increased. Or another way you could actually keep refreshing the value of your attributes is by using this neat little refresh interval that we have here on the right-hand side. Right now it lets you refresh attributes automatically on a one-minute basis or on a five-minute basis. Say, let's talk a little bit now about the attribute and operation filters. So I'm going to go back to the original example that we had here, which was a memory MBean. Not filter for anything. And we see that there's a lot of different kinds of attributes and operations that can be exposed. So say we're only interested in those attributes that end in usage. all you need to do is do dot star, meaning it will match any character, any kind of characters, followed by usage. You go to query, and we see that it's filtered out the last two attributes, which did not conform to this pattern. Similarly, we can do the same kind of thing, the operations. So let's go back to the original application MBean that we have. Let's say I'm only interested in operations that start with say. I would write something like this. Still interested in all kinds of attributes, so let's go ahead. There we go. We only see operations for say hello and say hello Ray. So I'm going to try this one out too. There we go. We have a return type of hello Gerardo. Let's try the same thing as an array. There we go. We return a type, which is a Java string array, which is hello is the first string, Gerardo is the second string. This is we would expect, and it's the same exact functionality that we saw through JVM, JConsole. So this pretty much covers the essentials of the JMX console functionality. Now we can go back to the slides and talk briefly about one advanced feature, which you've caught a glimpse of here, which is the preset searches. Right now we have two preset searches. One is all JVM platform MBeans. You can query for all MBeans that start with java.lang as their domain name. And then we also have another predefined filter, which is only the JVM memory MBean. And just for the sake of an example, this filter specifically is only interested in MBeans that have attributes. Well, it's only interested in those attributes pertaining to that MBean that end in usage. So as we see, we query, we only get those attributes that return in usage here. Let me go back to my slides. And I will show you, I'll talk a little bit about how we can actually go about defining those filters. So if you have your own application, you can define your own and not have the UI be cluttered by all kinds of stuff. Something we talked a little bit already about, filtering based on object name, attribute, and operation patterns. I showed you how you can do that through the UI. The same kind of functionality is available through the preset searches dropdown so that you don't actually have to go and type it in. But it's actually defined in an XML file, which is stored on the server side under this application. All this stuff is available online and on our wiki, so you don't need to rush and write this down, because I will actually point you to some documentation where all of this stuff is carefully documented, and you can refer to it at your leisure. So let me delve a little bit into the XML file and what kind of format that we use. So this is the XML file that we're actually using in this example. So remember I showed you that we had two kinds of filters. We had a JVM platform MBean filter as well as a JVM memory MBean filter. So if you look at this slide, you'll see that the filter has an ID associated with it. This ID is what's used in the preset filter dropdown, populate that dropdown. So when we looked at that dropdown before, we saw that there were two entries, one for JVM memory MBean, and another corresponding to JVM platform MBean. Now, associated with that filter ID, we can specify three kinds of filters. The first is the filter-based object name pattern. So here we see a java.lang colon type equal memory. That's what we saw in the object name pattern text field. Similarly, we have an attribute regular expression. In this case, we're all interested in those attributes that end in usage, and an operation regular expression, because we're interested in all kinds of operations. And very similarly with the JVM platform MBeans, here we're filtering based on a different object name pattern, in this case java.lang, anything under that domain will be queried for, and then any kinds of attributes and any kind of operations. So if you had your own application and you wanted to actually incorporate your own filter, it would just be very simple. One way would be to go into this file, add a whole new filter element, use an ID for whatever name you want to show in the dropdown, and input your patterns for object name and attribute and operation, regular expression, and that's how you do it. You could also just drop in a brand new file here. You could have one file per application. You don't have to get all in one single file. So that's up to you. So this pretty much covers how you would go about setting up your JMX console filters. And now we're actually reaching the end of the presentation. We have quite a bit of material to take in. So if you actually want to go through the documentation and, you know, some of those long URLs or server-side locations for the XML file, all that kind of stuff that I've talked about before, you can find it on our wiki. You don't have to memorize it right now, although, of course, these slides will be available online. They will be archived. So this is the URL that you can go to. It's support.hyperic.com/display/hq40/ui-monitor.server.mbeanbrowser. Of course, that will be available in the slide, so you can refer to it at your own leisure. So with this further pointer to the documentation, I actually conclude the presentation, and we can get started with the question and answer session. Well, it looks like there's no questions, so I will just be ending the conference now. Thank you, everyone, for your time. Bye-bye.